Welcome to BMC's Control-M self-service overview video. This video is intended for Control-M administrators. As an administrator, you will learn how to set up services that can be viewed by end users in the Control-M self-service web application and become familiar with the web application interface. End users need IT and application services on a daily basis. They have high expectations and demands for access to services that support their job functions. Control-M self-service gives end users the access and control they need by providing visibility into their application processing and historical data from any device. Users can also view high-level business services or drill down to the jobs in the service. In addition, users can perform basic tasks, such as troubleshooting failed jobs or ordering workflows. Last, Control-M self-service helps users make decisions in real time and frees up IT staff. In Control-M self-service, end users can view existing job flows in the Active Jobs database, or you can divide the job flows into organized containers called services. Creating services helps end users view their workflows and operations in an organized manner. A service is a group of one or more jobs that are collected based on job filtering criteria, order date, smart folder, or a job. A service can be for specific jobs within a broader process, such as the jobs that contain calculations in an inventory process or file transfer jobs. You can also control who has access to the specific services and the actions they can perform by setting user or group authorizations in the CCM. If you need a service for an ad hoc action, such as generating a report, you can create an orderable service. Orderable services enable end users to run their own workflows. Note that you can also view BIM services from the Control-M self-service web application. In order for end users to view services in the web application, you need to create service definitions in the Service Definition Manager. A service definition determines which jobs appear in the service, such as all jobs that start with the letters HR. You can manually create a service definition for each service, or you can define a service rule that generates service definitions automatically. A service rule organizes jobs into different services based on filtering and grouping criteria that you define. For example, you can filter for all jobs that belong to application HR and group those jobs into services based on the sub-application. When a job that belongs to application HR enters the Active Jobs database, the service rule criteria determines if it is added to an existing service or if a new service needs to be created. Now let's create a service rule that will generate the service definitions. To open the Service Definition Manager, from the Tools domain, click Services, Services Definition. To create a new rule, we'll click New Service Rule. Here you enter a name and a description for the service rule. When the active checkbox is selected, services are created automatically from this rule. In the selection screen, you select the criteria for filtering jobs in the active environment. Using our example, we will include all the jobs that belong to the application HR. In the grouping screen, you define how your jobs are grouped into services. You group your jobs into services based on different parameters, per smart folder, or per job. Using our example, we will select the first option to group jobs to services according to sub-application. This means that there will be a service for each sub-application. We have three sub-applications that begin with HRA, HRB, and HRC. This means that all jobs that belong to sub-application HRA will be in the same service, while jobs in HRB will be in another service. In the property screen, you determine how each service will be named. We will keep the default, so each service will have the name of the sub-application. According to this format, it will create services called HRA, HRB, HRC, and so on. In the Review Services screen, the list of service definitions that will be created from the rule appear. Let's take a look at the services we created in the web application. In the web application, you can see the status of the services in your environment here. In the Services tab, you can see the HRA and the HRB services, which were created by the rule that we defined. For each service, in the right pane, you can view general, parameter, and log information. If you double-click on a service, it opens up the jobs view, where you can see all the jobs in the service. Right-clicking a job shows the available job actions that end users can perform, such as rerunning a job or updating job parameters. You can restrict access to these actions from the ControlMEM Authorizations utility in the CCM. As we mentioned earlier, in the Jobs tab, end users can search for any job in the Active Jobs database and perform actions, as long as they have the necessary permissions. Additionally, end users can click Order Service to order services from the Active Jobs database. To enable this option, you need to create an orderable service definition. As an administrator, you can customize the web application settings, such as the site logo path or the refresh rate in the CCM. For more information, see the ControlM online help. Let's take a look at what we learned in this video. End users need access to services that support their daily job functions. Using ControlM self-service, end users can view existing job flows in the Active Jobs database. Creating services helps end users view their workflows and operations in an organized manner. You create service definitions in the Service Definition Manager. You can manually create a service definition for each service, or you can define a service rule that creates service definitions automatically. After you have defined service rules or definitions, end users can view the services in the web application. You can also allow end users to order services. Thank you for watching this video. To find out more information about ControlM self-service, see the ControlM online help at docs.bmc.com.